Once this is done in 7 hours, I think it's a West Barbican I'll be doing up, and I'll just be ticking them off. But essentially, as soon as that's done, this person will be going over there, and that's just to ward off any invaders and stuff like that. We'll just get on with the main story. Like I say, we've done level one, Cade Noir. I'm just going to probably attempt level two, see what that's like,
My
take it
eyes
from
are
there.
peeled.
Already done it. Someone, oh, aye, because I've already been in this place. Was it? So this door was blocked
Here
the
we
last time?
are. To think we are so close. Beneath our very feet lie the endless paths built by Ard Nua, the great Angwithan king. Well, up here, this is all Adirin, of course. But should we descend far enough, we will find some real history.
Real history.
To uncover that great king's tomb would be a dream. But it is one of his servants I am after. Gabranos, a powerful mage and a dedicated scholar. A keeper of lore, just as I mean to be.
Ooh.
He was in possession of the Tanvi Oratoa, or whatever form of it preceded the one we know. I've seen it in ruins, alongside Gabranos' name. Scraps of the same symbols and verses we know in Rauatai. He must have held the words in high regard. Or perhaps he was even the author.
Okay then, you sound very impressed by Gabranos. You see, he held power over the elements, Karakos, but I'm more interested in his writing. He was a prolific author. I haven't been able to translate everything, but I've seen enough to know that he travelled far and wide. If only we could have met him, what wisdom he could share, but we can follow his example and strive to learn from those around us. Improve upon it. I haven't read his writing. Well, not entirely. How could I? It's a dead language, and hardly anyone has translated even a small fraction of it. But what little I can, I have translated. By comparing the symbols in his works to what others have found, I pieced together a phrase from the Tavi Oratoa, clear as day. I even gave it to the keeper to check, but she was unconvinced I'd written it myself. So she was convinced I had written it myself. Okay, what does this book matter so much? Ratutai faces troubled times. Once we were unified people, but that's changing, and the Tanvi Oratoa is the heart of that. There are those who say that we haven't held to its instructions, that we've allowed ourselves to grow weak and polluted over traditions by welcoming foreigners rather than laying claim to the lands around us, that we must hold to those traditions if we are to make ourselves a nation to be feared. My brothers would have it so, but we don't need to isolate ourselves to make Rauatai great. Rauatai. I keep forgetting if it's Rauatai or Rauatai. And I know there's more to the chant. It wasn't created out of sand and water 1,000 years ago, but brought to Rauatai by the Angwithans, by a people that knew the value of alliances and shared the knowledge with us. And with that knowledge, we made Rauatai what it is today. If I can find the original, I can prove it. They'll know what the chant is far older than we believe. That the Angwithans favoured peace and the trade of knowledge. If we follow in their footsteps, we can make a kingdom just as grand and lasting as theirs. Okay, averting conflict is a noble affection. Like I say, I'm diplomatic, so I'll go for that. I don't know if there may be like more answers to these ones, but I'll just stick with that one. And a lofty one, I know. Kinda grins. I'm glad you feel the same. I feel it's better course for Rauatai. We're a people of many races, but we've also stood together. I feel we are destined for greatness. Let's start looking then.
If my sources are correct, Gabranos will have brought the text with him. It will probably be within a library, or a tomb perhaps. It tends to be one of the two. Let's be off.
Let's be off. It is. So, explore, explore, explore.
Let's see what lies this way.
Lies this way. So, I've already decked out everybody that I need to. We'll see how it goes. With that tonight, because they're going to come to me. Start attacking that. We'll start attacking. Get rid of that priest, but if we can start bulking them off. Oh, quite a few. You're right there. Damage this yet because it's gonna happen. Watching. I wonder why it wasn't dying. Being a fool. Being a fool. It's being fierce. Need to get back into it again. Been like, mm-hmm. Been missing a day and it's like already I'm forgetting how to play.
Time to see and not be seen.
Ooh.
All right then.
Oh, crap. Okay, that's nice. and dangerous. A trigger just trapped and didn't even know about it. Yeah, I don't know what it is, folks. I've been having issues with the sound. I've checked all the cables and everything seems fine. It's just, I don't know, maybe it's just this game, wasn't it? I've noticed as well that even on certain videos that I watch, the audio is like the focal audio is really bad. Can't understand why that is. It is what it is. Any time, which I'm fine with. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Lock you down. To there with you. I don't know, sometimes they just make very weird decisions. Yeah, she's like, she's stuck. She can't get around, which is weird. Alright. The key's stuck as well. Why doesn't this go through this gap? I don't know. That's a bit odd. I think this goes round and round in circles. Yeah, sometimes the AI is just a little bit bizarre, but got through that unscathed almost. So.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what lies this way.
You might find this interesting.
You don't want to get hit by that this time. Broken blade. This is the upper half of a broken blade. The metal is of fine quality, and it is unclear what caused it to snap neatly in the midpoint. Find more pieces of the ancient. Right. What, unscathed?
Eh?
What's my formation?
Sure.
Thank you. Very odd. He's like, yeah, I'll just move right behind you and not do anything. A good plan, mate. Sounds like a good plan. It's odd. It's odd that they have this behaviour, but... That's what you're doing. Good damn, good health, but... Yeah. A little troubling.
Mm-hmm.
Quickly and quietly.
Zarok was lying in a corner of the chamber, its ribs show starkling beneath its scaly hide, and its breathing is labored. Each whistling breath causes obvious discomfort. Doesn't seem to be reacting to your presence. Salmon, you look at the creature over. There is a strange discoloring of its skin in several places, but you cannot see anything that would inform you of what ails the soul. Well, if this is anything to do like with the first one we got before, oh wait. Anything that, can ail. Oh, this creature. Busy all of a sudden. Okay, I think I've got the prawn.
Yes.
Much damage here. Get right into the middle there. Hearing me or something. One of them. Let's try and lock you down. A bit aggro onto you.
That's it.
Yeah.
There one fewer.
He would be down by now.
Ah,
Oh, for now, like. Curved against the inside of the broken shell is a tiny white shape. Only when a tiny toothed maw opens to let out a frightened squeak, it is clear that this is a small worm recently hatched. Why would I have something like that? The rest up here. I don't have many spells left.
How may I help?
What?
Spells are you?
Yeah.
A bally thing, eh?
A bally thing? It's mallet. But that's there, so. Through these as quickly as possible.
I have
getting to have that as well. Everybody along. Yeah, what you're playing at, right?
Yeah. deal with this one. Let's go!
I think we'll probably heal up and go back up there and grab that.